Can I just ask you, Billy, what does it feel like when you're dancing?
Deka, you play Billy's dad in this musical. What kind of dad are you?
Well, a bit confused and a bit lost at the beginning. But that's the joy of it, is that he goes from being a guy who doesn't know how to talk to his son, how to connect to his son, and who's in a pretty grim place, to a guy who remembers what it is to love his son, you know, which is a brilliant journey for the audience and also for me as an actor. You know?
Absolutely. And we don't kind of, at the beginning, when he is, as you say, sort of not the greatest dad, we don't sort of, he's not kind of a villain in any way, is he? He's very forgiven.
Hopefully he's the audience see him just as somebody who acts the way he does because he can't cope or doesn't know how to cope, which doesn't make him, he's not malicious, he's just struggling, which is like I say, it's a great balance to play for an actor.
You always wanted to play this particular role?
I've always had my eye on it, yeah. I was sort of too young when it first came out. I was too old to play Tony and too young to play the dad. But, you know, over time, I've...
You've grown into one of the roles.
I've matured, yeah.
Because you're from the Northeast yourself, aren't you?
Yeah.
So what is that like, kind of portraying... Obviously, let's kind of put Billy's story aside for a minute. What's going on kind of politically with sort of the miners' strikes, etc.? That's, you know, a horrendous story, or, you know, factual thing that happened. Was that difficult for you, or was that an honour sort of for you to portray on stage?
Yeah, definitely the second one. It's an honour. I mean, it's something that, you know, is very close to my heart and to a lot of people who are brought up in the Northeast. So to get the chance to tell a story about how amazing these communities were and how brave and how they fought is an absolute honour. And you kind of do it for those people, really. Yeah.
And done in a way that actually people who, I don't know, if you're from London and you like me, I wasn't alive at the time and it was going on, but actually because you're sort of seeing that side of things through Billy's story, the kind of amalgamation of this boy caught in the middle of it all is really powerful, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it's not a story about the miners' strike, it's a story about a kid, and the backdrop is the miners' strike, and so all the echoes of that work, but at its heart, it's a story about a kid who has an ability and a family who can't really see that ability, or to whom that ability is alien. Yeah. And that's the nub of the story, which is why it works in London or in Holland or in Germany or in America. Mm. Because it's a story about a family, you know.
Did you face, when you were kind of starting out in this career, did your family kind of a bit like Billy's family at all?
Not from my family, but, you know, sort of people I was at school with would probably, I think some of them would go, "You're doing what?" You know, because it just wasn't something that, you know, there were odd people who had done it. I don't mean that people were odd. I mean,
there were a
few people who'd done it. And I sort of looked at them as role models, but not like big stars or anything, just men who had worked in local theatre and who I'd gone to see in plays. And they just looked like giants, you know. And I remember feeling like so overpowered by them. And it just made me think, I could do that. It seemed like a sort of another world, but I knew I could do it. And it was just having the courage to go, how do you begin that journey, you know, and going to drama school and things like that. No, your family are very supportive and proud, really.
In a way, then, you had sort of the electricity moment that Billy talks about?
My electricity moment was my best friend, who was the original George, Trevor Fox, applied to a drama school and got in, and we were both in a youth theatre with Lee Hall as well. And the day he came and told us that he got into drama school, something clicked in my head. I was supposed to go to university and do English and American literature or something boring, yeah. And something clicked, and I went, do you know what, if he can do it, I can do it. And so I, you know, I've got him to thank, really. He had the courage to apply in the first place, and I just kind of went, oh, well, I'm going to have a go, you know. So, and that was my sort of electricity moment of going, I can do this. And then it was really odd and alien coming to London, and it was very kind of a different world from where I'd come from. And certainly the work at the beginning of drama school was slightly tricky, and I felt very self-conscious. But, you know, over 3 years, basically, there's no secret to it. You do lots of plays that you would never get cast in professionally, because you just don't suit the part, but you just learn by doing, I think. And if you have a knack for it, or an eye or an ear or a feel for it, then you either go for it or you don't. And I just knew I was going to go for it.
Do you then, I mean, you work with all the Billies, do you have to sort of respond differently to each of those Billies? Because obviously they're an age where they are all so different. Is it a different show with a different Billy?
Yeah, because they're different people and they play moments differently. You know, there are parameters and they have to be in the same place and, you know, physically. But no, they all play moments very differently and you know, they rotate every night. So that's a brilliant thing for me to, because you could get lazy.
Does it keep it fresh?
Yeah, absolutely. And it's your job, you know, to, if you're just on autopilot, then you're not doing your job. You've got to respond to what's given to you and what the audience give to you. And that's why people go, you've been in it for how long? Are you not bored? No, I'm just not, you know.
And particularly now, so this is going to be filmed live on Sunday and it's going out, being streamed to cinemas. Is that sort of an exciting opportunity? Because I guess the theatre is something that not everybody goes to. Not everybody has that opportunity. So sending it to cinemas is going to sort of open up this story to a whole group of people that otherwise might miss it.
Yeah. I mean, that's the beauty of it, is that people who can't get to London can just go to a local cinema and be involved with it and take part, you know. And hopefully that will be... I think the aim of it is to make them feel as if they are here, you know, so they are a part of it, even though they're, you know, either across an ocean or, you know, 600 miles away or whatever, is to make them feel included and for all the things that are brilliant about the show to reach across onto a screen as well. So it's not like a film of Billy Elliot, it's a film of a theatrical experience that not everyone could get the chance to see, so we're trying to give them access to it.
What is it about Billy Elliot then as a theatre production? Why does it have this sort of enduring appeal and it's been around for so many years? Everyone wants to see it. What is it?
I think it was brilliantly put together in the first place. You know, all the creative team absolutely at the top of the game. I think it's a brilliant, brilliant story. Who doesn't want to love a kid who wants to have a go? You know, and it's the kids that are the secret to it. And that, because people are absolutely falling in love with them. And you always want to root for an underdog, you know, and he tries so hard. And the other thing is, the Billies are, they make the rest of us look like idiots. Honestly, they are.
Really?
Oh, man, they're just ridiculously talented. And they absolutely pour off the stage and the audience absolutely lap it up, you know. And it's a really brilliant theatrical retelling of the film. You know, people come and say, oh, it wasn't anything like the film, but of course it's not, because it's in a theatre, and if you're in a theatre, you might as well use all the theatricality that you can to tell the story. So it's a brilliant mix of choreography that tells a story, of dance that tells a story, of a script that tells a story, and of music that tells a story, and they all just fit together so brilliantly. I wish I was as talented as that lot.
As the young ones. I know, it's even watching them warm up. Yeah, oh, my God, you could do that?
I can't turn around and look at them. They make me feel old.
I know, don't. What is next for you? How long are you sort of doing this run for?
I'm contracted until May 2015, and then I'll see. I mean, I'm sure we'll start talking about what I want to do at some point, you know, Christmas, just New Year. But I don't know. I mean, I absolutely love it. I'm very happy, and I'm very at home here, and I like the family atmosphere, and it's a cracking part. So I don't know. We'll talk about that. Cross that bridge when we come to it. They might want to get rid of me.
Oh, I don't think they will. That'd be silly. You never know. Yeah. Get a younger dad in. I don't know. Yeah.
No, if they get an older one, I'll be happy.
Get an older one. Yeah.
If they get a younger one, I'll chase them.
Yeah. If he needs to be older, you know, you're right with that. And finally, we're from the fan carpet today. What are you a fan of?
What, in general?
Yeah.
Guitars.
Do you play?
Yeah. A fan of guitars, I'm a fan of riding my bike, and if I could fix it for myself, I also used to be a drummer in a band, and I gave it up to go to drama school, and if I could fix it for myself, I would like to play the drums with, I don't know, some ridiculously loud rock band, just for one night, you know.
That would be awesome. Or get back into a band.
I haven't got the time.
Have you ever gone down there, and how'd I go?
Yes, but don't tell the drummer.
Slightly to steal his sticks when he's not looking.
It's great, and I miss it. I really miss it, and it's the one I don't regret not being in a band. And I was glad I went to drama school, but I really miss playing the drums.
Yeah, I bet. It's quite good. They're a good thing to play, aren't they? There's a lot of tick a lot of boxes.
I enjoy the guitar, but I miss the kind of physical thrash of playing the drums, and it gets you out of a bad mood. Yeah. And I'm basically like making noise. So drums were perfect for me.
Well, give that a go again. I would be an advocate of that.
I think what I'll do is I will treat myself to... I've still got my drums, and I will hire a hall somewhere, and I'll just have a day where I try and remember how to...
Have a good play.
Yeah.
A special performance. Billy Elliot, the musical live. Winner of 80 awards globally.
We're proud to be working class.
With music by Elton John.